Yo, what's good, Broskies? It's your boy Ronnie, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we're back with another reaction to Steven Universe. Last few episodes were pretty cool. I think we got some level of confirmation that Amethyst, no man, Garnet has some level of a sixth sense. It wasn't 100% confirmation, but I feel like it's there. And we pretty much got introduced to the concept of gem fusions, which is, I don't know, a pretty cool thing. But what I really loved was how in all of that, they were able to explore the tension that exists between Amethyst and Pearl. I think there's a bit of friction there that exists. And, you know, it was a good way to explore that without... It was a good way to explore that without actually making it the main point of the episode. So, some great storytelling happening here. But let's focus on the new episode and start the reaction. What are we looking for? A burrito. Don't eat it.
How old are you guys?
Much older than any human.
Does that mean you live forever?
No, we don't age, but we can still get hurt and die.
But in general, you're going to live forever if you avoid damage.
I pledge that you will have your birthdays with all the candies, cake, and ice cream you've been.
But like, how are gems born? Like, what's going on?
It goes like this.
No one is too old for birthday celebrations.
Wait! Here!
Aww, I'll use it all the time.
No!
That defeats the purpose!
Happy birthday!
Bonk! Steven! That is a great look.
No, it's funny.
How?
Wow, they don't get human humor?
I sure hope nothing happens to it.
Yes, me too.
This is gonna end so badly.
Whoa, Steven.
Oh, it's part of the joke.
Pearl says she's all partied out and she's ready to go home.
This isn't going at all like it should. Dad used to do this for me every year.
I think this is why aging makes humans die.
Thank you for the birthday parties, but I don't think we'll need any more.
Which way to the baby war?
Eat tread,
dirtbag!
What if birthdays are just for little kids? What if even I'm too old?
No.
Nah, you still need to enjoy this thing.
All these parties? Ugh, so embarrassing.
Is he AJ?
I need to take control of my life. It's time to get a proper job. But which one? Surfmaster?
Bro, did you just walk into a shop? It looks closed. Oh. Bruh. He's
jokes. But you know what?
So much.
I've got a lot of time to think today, and sometimes you gotta smarten up. Act like an adult. Ah!
Sir, are you okay?
He's only known to...
Old!
Duh!
Nuts.
Will you help me into my birthday suit?
Makes me feel important.
Steven! What's wrong with him?
Good as new.
He isn't! I think he needs to start thinking that he's a bit younger.
It's all out of birthday magic.
I sincerely hope that nothing happens to...
Hey, yo! I thought this was a kid show. Does he look younger? That is so unreal.
No, Steven, don't get near that stuff.
Steven's here.
careful, Steven.
It's lost.
It's not lost.
It's looking for its mother.
Yes, but Rose loved it anyway. She saw the beauty in everything, no matter how gross.
Is this police tape?
Isn't this great?
It's like when I asked with Gunner.
I don't even have to use magic. Humans will just see this and walk away.
I can generate everything from their hand.
Don't hold back.
With the gems.
I never do.
Give me a pizza.
Why is he trying to act cool?
Yeah. Why now?
Got a high five for you.
Why are you always so shitty to Steven, though? I'm thinking like we need to discuss this.
How come you're not at the big donut?
He opened the door and there was doggy doo everywhere.
That's nasty.
Oh, so these are the cool kids.
Isn't that Kiki's sister and her friends?
The plan is to keep it cool and let them come to me.
Yeah, that's not how friends are made.
Steven, turn around, act natural.
Tell Dad I'll be back later.
My name's Steven.
Buck Dewey.
They call me Sour Cream.
I'm Jenny.
Jenny, Buck Dewey.
He's gonna wreck everything.
Sour Cream.
What are they saying?
Hop on in, guys.
Oh, yeah, middle seat. Sounds like it's time to buckle up.
Quit being lame, Steven.
Hey, man.
Don't be that dude.
There's nothing lame about seatbelt safety.
Isn't that your dad?
Another reason you should re-elect me? I love babies. Will you look at that, a baby?
Oh, my gosh, guys. We should check out Dead Man's Mouth.
What's Dead Man's Mouth?
Oh, is this lake where some dude died? Or it looks like a mouth?
I know this place may seem cool, but it's actually a lot less cool than you think.
Who wants to go for a swim?
You are going to die. You are going to die. That's his deal.
Lars, I know what we have to do.
This is all your fault.
Don't be a dick.
I knew if something went wrong today, it would be because of you.
What do you know about my mom?
Exactly.
I didn't even get to know my mom. Lars, hurry.
Ignition.
Stick power.
Yeah. Oh. That is so dope. That is so dope.
Okay, that's enough.
That was a cool episode. You know, some important knowledge dropped on us, which is gems are low-key kind of immortal. Like, the gems don't age. That's messed up. That means either way, yo. So if Steven's mom didn't disappear, that means she would have outlived Steven's dad anyway. Like, it kind of also brings in the question of, are the gems going to outlive Steven? Or is Steven, now that he's discovered that when he shifts his mental state, he can change his age, is Steven just gonna choose one single age where he's like, I'm gonna stay this age forever, think this way, and that's that? Or, I don't know, man, but it's just, it just gets my mind racing. And I don't know, man. Should I be uncomfortable with the amount of near-death experiences that we had in these two episodes? Steven literally almost died. And his friends that he just met literally almost died. Like, the fact that this show is willing to take it there, I don't know, man. As we move on, it started to look like less of a kid's show. Or at the very least, it discusses, or at the very least, it finds a way to discuss things that normally you wouldn't find in a typical TV show. And I have to say, Lars is a bit of a shitty one, man. Like, I thought he just didn't like Steven, but like, yo, bruv, like, there's things that you need to sort out there with you. Like, Steven is a kid, so he'll probably forgive him like it's nothing. But, like, still, though. Genuinely still. Fuck Lars. Anyways, tell me how you feel. Did you like this episode? Did you not? Please, hit up that comment section, and we'll have a conversation. But other than that, thank you so much if you made it this far. Like and subscribe, and join the family. See you in the next one. Peace!